Well, it's been a while since the last update, so let's go and have a look behind the door, see what's been happening. What's been going on, you may ask? Well, track is all laid, screwed and pinned. I brought a point and a crossing so I can have a little engine shed area. One of my latest acquisitions is a Dapple Schools, lovely loco. Got some odd buildings what I brought second hand, a footbridge which is a Pico ratio kit which needs painting up, a Graham Farish station building which I picked up off a well-known auction site with a lot of my buildings, so don't, and a very nice Hornby little end signal box. Still debating what to put in this corner. I kind of like the idea of a tunnel, but it's making it. I don't know where to start. I've tried Sellotex, but it didn't work. So I've got to try and think of another way. Current fleet is a Farish N-Class, along with another Farish G&T. I think that's a class 25 from Dapple, lovely loco. The scores, as have you already seen, and the very old Farish pannier tank. So not too many locos, just the odd few, and I'm still using my trusty Gauge Master Q, great controller. So nothing much has happened, but at least my track's laid now after a couple of weeks of trial and error things. I also did put Sellotex on underneath of a board, so I thought, well, I'll give that a go. It didn't work, didn't go to plan, so I had to start from scratch again, use the other side of the board and put the old battens on the other side. So trial and error, it happens with model railways, and at the end of this video I'll put a compilation together of the build and a few trains running. So many thanks for watching and goodbye, see you in part 3.